Hello everyone, welcome back to the computer fundamental classes. In previous class we discussed about the architecture of computer or the basic organization of computer. We discussed in previous class, right? So you know already the what are the parts which are including computers. It may be hardware, it may be software, okay? These all things we saw in previous class, okay? Like input unit, output unit, okay? Then storage unit. In that there are two parts, one is primary storage and secondary storage, both are together storage unit. And the next one is control unit and arithmetic logic unit. These both are two unit called as central processing unit. See, one more thing. See, the human beings have a nervous system, right? Like humans have a brain. The what brain does? It maintain all nervous system. Okay, it coordinates all our nervous system. That is called as a brain. So, because in your computer, CPU. What is that stands for CPU? The central processing unit, right? The here the C stands for central, because the CPU is the brain of computer. You can say CPU is brain of computer, because this can handle the all units. The CPU coordinates, or it can manage, or it can handle the all units. That means it can direct the all units, how it works. Okay, that is called as CPU is the brain of computer system. Okay, in sometimes in exam they may ask which is the brain of computer. Okay, so you are right, the CPU is a brain of computer, like the human being's brain. The human being brain works, it manages all nervous system. Nervous system, okay, like this. Here also it manages all everything which is in computer. It coordinates all computer system, okay? So that is CPU. Now in this class we are going to study, so what is the concept of computer system? Okay, see, now we are going to discuss in this class computer system, right? Computer system concept. Computer system concept. See, up to in this class, see, we discussed about some concept, system. Okay, I am telling in every class the computer system. So what do you mean by computer system? Okay, you know already what you mean by computer, right? The computer is an electronic device which accepts the data from the user and process it, store it, okay, produce the output to the end user. That is called as computer. Now some people are saying computer system, not only computer, some people are telling a computer system. What do you mean by computer system? See, this is nothing but the computer system is nothing but computer, or we can say system, or we can say computer. See, this computer is referred to as computer system, right? And some people are refer this computer as a system. Okay, so according to them they are calling like this. Okay, so the computer we can refer the computer system also, okay, and computer we can refer system also. So this is called as the computer system. Okay, so what do you mean by computer system? So this is only refer, how it refers. Okay, so what are the synonyms we can say? These are the computer meaning same as computer system, also we can say the system. Okay, so what exactly computer system? Okay, what it includes? why you call the computer system, the computer is a computer system, why you call? Okay, so the reason behind is, this is because the system is a group of integrated parts. In previous class I also told you, okay, what is that? The computer system or computer or system is a group of the integrated parts. See here, this system is a group of integrated parts having common purpose of achieving some objectives, that is called as computer. Okay, group of integrated parts, these integrated parts having a common purpose of achieving objectives. Right? Objectives. Achieving some objective. That is called as a system or computer system. You can say, sometimes they may ask, write a concept of computer system. Then what you have to write? So first what you have to write? The computer, normally you can refer it as a computer system or a system. You can refer like this also. Then what you mean by computer system? Okay, what you mean by computer system? See, the computer system is a integrated or is a group of integrated parts. Okay, you know already. The computer is a group of integrated parts. It may be hardware, it may be software, anything. Okay, so that is called as computer. So here, when you come, the computer system, that is called as a group of integrated parts. Group of integrated parts. So what are the integrated parts? What it includes? What it contains? This computer system, what contains? Because we are saying group of integrated parts. What it means? See, for example, in previous class I discussed this computer architecture. This computer contains input units, okay, input units, and also output units, then storing unit, okay, then controlling and arithmetic logic unit. Okay, so these units together we can say the computer system. Okay, so because these are the individual part, the input unit is on individual part, output unit is the individual part, storing and controlling and arithmetic logic in it. Okay, these are the individual part. When you make it together, these all things into one system, that is called as computer system. So what are the using, why you make it together? Because to achieve some objective. So achieve some objective, like it can take the input from the user, then due to the storing device, then it can store the data. Okay, and after that the ALU, arithmetic logic unit, that process the data. Okay, after that it goes to the output unit, that produce the data to the user. Okay, every unit have some functions like this. Okay, so these are the some goals of the these parts. Okay, so these are the objective of these parts. Okay, so these are the individual units. When you group of these parts, we can say that is a computer system. Okay, that is a computer system. Okay, so in previous class we discussed the structure of computer, how it looks. Here there is an input, here storage device, then output device, then here ALU, ALU, control unit, storage unit, output unit and input unit. Okay, input unit, output unit. So here these two combination of control unit and arithmetic logic unit, we can say this is called as CPU, because this process the data and also it is the brain of computer. So here when you take the data from the user, it goes to the storage unit. Okay, input unit that supplies the data to the storage unit, it can save the data, save or store the data in primary memory or else secondary storage. Okay, after that the whatever stored data that supplies to the ALU, because it can process some data, because the purpose of the processing the data, we are supplying the data from the input device. Okay, that can store here, then supply here, and it can perform, it may be arithmetic logic, arithmetic or any logical operation. After that again it sent back to the storage unit. Okay, and it goes to the output unit. Output unit, what it does, that display the output to the user or it produces the result. Okay, so these are some functions of individual unit. Okay, so these together units, these units together, we can say the computer system. Okay, the computer system. So hence a system has the following some characteristics. Okay, so this computer system has three characteristics or features. Then only you can say this is a system. So what are the characteristics? I'll write here characteristics. What are those? The first one is, this computer system has more than one element. Okay, here I draw one example, the computer architecture. In that architecture there are more than one individual part, together we can make a computer architecture, right? So according to the definition of computer system, this system has a more than one element. Element means components or hardware parts, right? This computer system has more than one element. More than one element. Okay, then only we can say the computer system. After that, all its elements are logically connected. Okay, that is very very important. This second step, that second characteristics is very important. Okay, so what is that? All elements or all parts of the computer, all elements or all components are logically connected. Okay, because the individual unit cannot perform alone, because they need the help of other hardware system. See here, a dual input system. Okay, when that reads input from the user, that needs a CPU help. Okay, so that is some logically interconnected, the logically connected one by one. Okay, so all components are logically connected. So then after that, a storage unit cannot store directly, that needs the input unit help. When input unit reads the data from the user, then that supplies to the storage unit, then only it can take the data from the input unit. It cannot take directly from the user. With the help of input unit, the storage unit save the data. That is called as all units are logically connected. Then only we can say computer is a computer system. The third one is all its elements are controlled in manner to achieve a system goal. We discuss. Okay, now, so what is that? All its elements, or you can say all its components or hardware parts are controlled. How it's controlled? In manner way, in sequence way. Which purpose it is controlled? To achieve the system goals. What is the system goals here? The user that gives some task to the computer. The user, a giver, one task to the computer system. What is the task here? The simple thing, addition of two number is one task the user given to the computer in the form of the instruction. Okay, like a program. So according to that program, all units are works together to achieve this task, this goal, that is called as system goals. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Next one, the computer has an integrated components. We discussed input unit, output unit, storage unit and CPU, which works together to perform the steps called for in an executing program. Okay, it is a system. We can say it is called as the computer system. What is that? Okay, one more time. The all integrated parts like input unit, storage unit, output unit and CPU. In that CPU or particular logic unit and also control unit, which works together. The all units are works together to perform the task which is given by the user, called for an executing program. That means executing program, because in the form of program they given the instruction, the user given the instruction to the computer in the form of program. Okay, so that is our task. Okay, so which works together to perform the task called for in an executing program, it is called as computer system. It is called as computer system. I hope this is clear to you. So what do you mean by computer system? Okay, thank you. In next class, okay, so guys, in next class we are going to discuss what are the hardware or input devices or output devices. These all things we are going to discuss in next class. Okay, because they are important. What are the input parts? What are the output parts? That means input devices and what are the output devices we are going to discuss in next class. Okay, I hope this is clear to you up to this class. Okay, last one is class, that is called as input and output device. Then only you can complete the first unit. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Okay, thank you.